Hi everyone, I am Siva from Review Table. Welcome to Apple Bytes. Today, let's look at some of the settings that we should turn off right now. So before we look into those settings, I request you to subscribe to my channel to watch more videos like this. So let's get started. The first and foremost settings that we should be looking at are privacy settings. I do care about my privacy when I am using my phone. I think you do as well. So there are location services under privacy settings. So basically location services mean like they access your location, they determine your location using the GPS, Bluetooth or crowdsourced Wi-Fi hotspots. So we should be very careful about, you know, which apps are accessing your location and when they are accessing your location. To access those settings, we need to go to settings. For that, tap on settings, scroll down, tap on privacy, then tap on location services. Then if you scroll down, you can see all the list of apps that you have on your iPhone. So here you can choose how you want to give the access to your apps. So if I tap on, for example, one app here, you can see four options like never, ask next time while using the app, and always. Never means it will never access your location. Next one is ask next time. That means like it's kind of a provisional basis. That means like if I am using an app, it gets the access. But if I close the app and if it opens again, the app has to again request you to give the permission to access the location. It's kind of, you know, on demand. Next is while using the app. This means so whenever you use the app, then only to access your location. If you close the app, it will not access your location. Closing means even if you are not using it, if you minimize the app, it will not access your location. Next one is always. So whether you are using the app or when you minimize the app, whether it is running in the background, it keeps accessing your location. Here, what I recommend is to have these location services turned on only for certain, like, you know, they are very really needed for us, but you can decide, you know, as per your requirement. But I do recommend only these apps. You can have a look at these. So first thing is Apple Watch workout. If you have an Apple Watch and if you're doing workouts and if you want to get the correct data while you are walking or running, you can have this turned on, but you can give permission like only while using the app. And the other ones are you don't really need. For example, Citibank, do I really need to give the permission to access my location while using the app? No, never. So any other app, you can just, you know, put as a never. But the only things that you should have is like compass. So you can, you know, give the access permission like while using the app. There are other apps like, you know, dictionary. I don't need to give the permission. And this is very important for all of us, you know, who are using iPhone or Apple devices. So you better give while using the app permission so that, you know, when in case if you lose your Apple devices, it's very useful to detect the location. So other one is Google Maps. So basically you need services like, you know, maps, Find My iPhone, like in cab services and food delivery applications. For that, you can give access like, you know, while using. So other ones you can just give as a never, but it depends on how your situation is. Messenger, I don't really need to give access while I'm using Facebook Messenger. The cab services, as I mentioned, and the shortcuts. When it comes to shortcuts, I have some shortcuts, automations I am using on my phone, and certain automations need a location. So I gave as while using, but if you're not using it, that's fine. You can give as never. And other one is Swiggy, as I mentioned, food delivery. Weather, if you want to have a accurate weather, so you can give it as while using. So this is how I am using, and this is what I recommend, but you can choose, you know, as you require. But there is also one more option, like in system services. So if you go to system services, there are a lot of settings. I recommend you again to turn off these services, permissions to give your locations, except for only few. You can turn off for compass calibration, but emergency calls and SOS, you should have it turned on. So Find My iPhone, you should be having it turned on. Share My location, if you want to share your location at any time, if you have it turned on, you can give it right away. Otherwise, you have to come back to settings and turn this on. And Wi-Fi calling, if you're really using Wi-Fi calling, then you may need it. I'm going to make another video about how to use Wi-Fi calling. Next thing are iPhone analytics. So iPhone analytics, And you know, while you are using apps, it sends data about how you are using apps. So do you really require this data to be sent over to Apple or any other app developers? I don't think so. And I turn this off, and the popular near me, you know, it accesses your location, and it finds out, you know, what are the popular locations like restaurants or etc. around you. And it proposes you those locations. And I don't think it's really needed. Routing and traffic, but remember that, you know, it depends on your look, you know, your situation as well. And improve maps. If you are really using Apple Maps, it may be required. It's up to you. But I don't use Apple Maps in India because they are not up to date. I use Google Maps. Another settings that we should be looking at are in-app ratings and reviews. To access this, you need to go to settings, then scroll down to iTunes and App Store, tap on it, then scroll down, you can see in-app ratings and reviews. This is what we normally face. We download apps and we keep using them. But you know, more often we will be getting like pop-ups asking you to give the ratings and reviews about the apps. So sometimes this may be annoying to us, and you don't really have to, you know, send all these unless it is required. So I recommend you to turn these off. The next setting that we should be looking at is background app refresh. So to access this, go to settings, then tap on general, then tap on background app refresh. So what it does is, you can clearly see here, it says allow apps to refresh their content when on Wi-Fi or a mobile network in the background. Turning off apps may help preserve battery life. So even when you are not using the apps, they keep download the content of the app so that, you know, when you open the app, you have the data ready. So, but it is helpful sometimes depending on the apps that you want. But there are also settings for this. If you tap on background app refresh, there are three options. One is off, Wi-Fi and mobile data. So when this refresh should happen? So only while you are using Wi-Fi or Wi-Fi and mobile data as well. So I recommend to have Wi-Fi on, because, you know, if you use mobile data, it may use a lot of mobile data. And you can also choose which apps really require app refresh, I mean, refreshing the content. So for me, I turn off everything except, you know, maybe maps, Google Maps, because they're very useful. Otherwise, you can turn off everything else. In case of use Apple Maps, you can have it on, and otherwise you turn off for the rest. And other thing is, if you choose Wi-Fi, only Wi-Fi, you can have for more apps as well, because, you know, if you're home or some place where Wi-Fi is enabled, it's okay, because, you know, it saves, even it doesn't take much battery life when compared to on the mobile data. The next one is push notifications and email. To access this, go to settings, then scroll down to passwords and accounts, tap on it. Then you can see list of email accounts that you have set up. What push notifications do is, it constantly looks for emails. So by doing so, it consumes more battery as well as data. So we have another option in place of push notifications. If you tap on fetch new data here, you see push, okay? And if I turn it on, you know, it does what I just discussed. Turn it off, and you have one more option. It has fetching. Fetching means, like, you know, we set up the we schedule the intervals at which it should look for the emails. Every 15 minutes or every 30 minutes or for every hour or manually. Manually means, I prefer manually. Manually means, like, only when you open an app, then only it looks for mails or it refreshes the inbox. So by doing so, it saves battery as well as data. If you are really worried about the data and battery life, these are the settings that you should be thinking about to turn off. And in addition to these, there are also other settings that we should be considering, or I recommend to turn them off right now. These are very important settings. Those are, like, you know, if you go to privacy again, tap on privacy, then you can see the Photos app. You should be thinking about which apps, you have a lot of apps on your iPhone, and you should be thinking, you know, which apps are accessing my photos. This is really important. If you don't give the access accordingly, you know, we don't know where the photos are going to. So you should be choosing between never and read and write. You can choose, you know, depends how you want it. If you want, you're posting photos to Instagram or any social media app, and if you don't give access, then you can, you know, you cannot post the photos as well. So by considering those, you can change the settings that you want. But if you think that, you know, if you're not using it for a while and you don't need it, just, you know, turn it off or choose as never. Similarly, there is a camera app. So this is very important as well. And there are a lot of apps, you know, we usually have a lot of apps, and we need to be very careful about, you know, which apps are using our camera. At the same time, if you go back, microphone, this is also very important. And, you know, make sure that, you know, only the apps that we regularly use and which really need access to microphone should be having this turned on. If you take, you know, YouTube Kids, YouTube, and I don't really need WhatsApp, maybe I need for voice calls. And WebEx, depends on your use. You know, Twitter, if you don't post, you know, anything which is which requires a microphone, just turn it off. And Instagram, so it depends how you want it. Hyperlapse, this is completely different app, you don't need a microphone for that. The very, very important setting is like giving full access to third-party keyboards. To access this, tap on General and Settings, then scroll down to Keyboard, then tap on Keyboard. And if you tap on Keyboards, you see the list of keyboards that you have enabled. And in my case, I have only one keyboard here, which is third-party. And you don't see this option of, you know, giving allow full access to native keyboards from Apple. So if you tap on third-party one, you can see allow full access. Let's see what happens if you grant the full access to this third-party keyboard. So see what Apple says here. Full access allows the developer of this keyboard to transit anything you type, including things you have previously typed with this keyboard. This could include sensitive information such as your credit card number or street address. Do you really need to give full permission and send your sensitive information over to a developer? I don't think so, right? So you always better tap on don't allow. This is very, very important. So whatever you type will go to the developer of the app, and we don't know what they might be doing with our information. So these are some of the settings that we should be turning off right now. And this is what I recommend, but you can make a decision based upon your situation and your requirement as well. So, but because, you know, you may be using different apps, I might be using different apps, and the requirements may be different, but you should be considering these settings right now. Hope this video is helpful to you. And if you really enjoyed the video, like it and share with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Jai Hind.